Now in the past, we have talked a lot about flying monsters and pterodactyls in my previous videos. And thanks to Nick Redfern from MysteriousUniverse.org, I have just uncovered another amazing mass sighting, and this time in the UK. Imagine driving home one night across the foggy moors of England when all of a sudden you see a huge, featherless bird flying right above your car. And it appears that this bird was on fire, or could maybe breathe fire, kind of like a dragon. But it didn't look like a dragon, it just looked like a huge bird. Something from the Jurassic period. And of course these people were scared out of their minds, and they all saw this bird very closely. And they said to themselves that it looked exactly like a pterodactyl or a pterosaur. And this once in a lifetime sighting stuck with them for the rest of their lives. And still to this day, they head out to the spooky location and look for this bird. Now during 1977, 1983, and even today, this giant bird, or birds, or whatever they are, have been seen in and around this exact same location, the Devil's Punch Bowl in England. Another creepy encounter took place right next to this area on September in 1982 by a man named William. William was taking his morning hike when all of a sudden he saw a huge featherless bird flying right above him. He stated that this bird was just massive and it looked exactly like a flying dinosaur. He also went on to say that its skin was like leather and that its wingspan was enormous, and that it was also making a very strange sound. And just 72 hours later, a woman named Jean had also seen this huge flying monster, and yet again right next to the Devil's Punch Bowl. And this sighting was very interesting, because Jean was convinced that this massive, odd-looking bird was going to crash into an airplane, because it was heading right towards the airport. So she called the police, and the media got a hold of this story, just freaking everybody out. And after this segment aired, they got a lot of calls coming from people saying that they too had seen this bird. Some of them even claimed that they had been seeing them for years. Now after the media released this story, and with so many eyewitnesses now coming forward, this created a mass panic. And people from all over the place went to this location in hopes of finding whatever this was. Now after a couple of days, and after the hysteria kind of died down a bit, a man named Richard, who was also taking his morning walk through the Devil's Punch Bowl with his dog, claimed that he had been dive bombed by this bird, leaving him and his dog lying on the floor screaming for their lives. And when Richard finally got a good look at this bird, he said that it was a pterodactyl, or something very similar, and that it just shouldn't exist in this day and age. Now after all these sightings during the late 70s and early 80s made a lot of people wonder what exactly was this thing. Some say that it was a remote control of a huge bird, but every single one of these eyewitnesses dismissed this theory. They said that there was just no way that this monster could have been something mechanical. They said that this was a real living breathing animal that looked like it came right out of the ashes of time. And there are still sightings going on to this very day. But they're a lot rarer than they used to be. And a lot of people are still looking or trying to catch this thing to prove to the world that these birds do exist. And also, there are a lot more sightings going on all the time of birds that look just like this. And they are known as the Ropin. And they are mainly seen throughout South America and especially Africa. And the Ropin looks exactly like a pterosaur. With the exception that it can glow at night. But this mass sighting that happened in England got me thinking about the Devil's Punch Bowl. Could this spooky location still be a place where monsters still exist to this very day? Until next time, this is Paranormal Junkie. Please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, my Facebook page, and my Twitter, because you never know what paranormal stories you might miss. And as always, thank you for watching.